listen. Again, we move to the next class, that is immune formation. Immune formation, it occurs in three steps. Already I told you. That is, what are the steps? The first one, it is ultrafiltration. The second one, tumular reabsorption. And the third one, tumular secretion. This one, that is tumular reabsorption, we can say selective reabsorption, we can say selective, because all are not reabsorbed, those are the useful that should be reabsorbed. Each immune, it consists of millions of substructures. Such means, that is the nephron. What is the other name of the nephron? The nephron, it is also known as uriniferous tubules or nephron. This is the unit of the kidney. This kidney, when the renal artery, it is entered into the kidney, that is, these renal artery, they form a number of branches. And when the artery, they form a number of branches that are called arterioles. That is, that the branches of the artery which enter, and that means the glomerulus, which we already discussed, it is a network of blood capillaries. Ultimately, what is it? It is mainly, that is, the branch of renal artery which enter into the kidney, which bring, what happened? Which they bring to the mesenteric body, that is, we get. This is the structure. We make it here. These are called, that is, the artery which bring towards the part, towards the organ, that are called afferent. So it bring, that means through which the blood is come. These are called afferent arterioles. Afferent arteriole. So these afferent arteriole, they bring oxygenated but toxic blood where to the glomerulus, that is the network. And the blood vessels through which it is leaves the glomerulus, that are called efferent arterioles. That are called efferent arterioles. So we bring oxygenated toxic blood back to the glomerulus, and the blood vessels which carry blood away from the glomerulus, that are called efferent arterioles. That means all these are the branch of renal artery. They form from the renal artery. Afferent arterioles, they bring the blood which come to the afferent arterioles. If you observe the diagram very carefully, you will see that is the lumen of the afferent arterioles, it is twice than the efferent. It is twice than the efferent. The lumen is twice than the efferent. So the force by which the blood is entered into the glomerulus, the same force it not leaves. Why? Because the main of the efferent, it is twice less than the afferent. As a result, a tremendous pressure it is developed where? Inside the glomerulus. And the fluid part of the blood that oozes out from the glomerulus. What for? Due to tremendous pressure, which is caused due to the difference in the lumen of afferent and efferent arterioles. The tremendous pressure which is formed in the glomerulus, so that the fluid part, it is oozes out, that are called ultrafiltration. And when the ultrafiltration is taken, the fluid part is come, and these, that is the Bowman capsule, it is made up of a single layer of cell. So ultimately the fluid, it is enter where inside the Brahman capsule and it disperses. The fluid which oozes out from the glomerulus that are called glomerular filtrate, or it is called primary UV or glomerular filtrate or nitric filtrate. And this substance, it is not only consists of the waste materials, there we get some useful materials are also present. The first thing we get there is the nitrogenous waste, urea, uric acid are also present, as well as it also contains the glucose as well as the amino acid. But these glucose and amino acid, they are the useful substance that should not be released from the body to the urine. So what happened? The useful substances should be reabsorbed. Now who will reabsorb? That is the renal tubules, which are made up of only one cell. That is again that are reabsorbed. So when the primary urine of the nephric filter passes through the renal tubules, I already told you these are called, PCT, when it is passed through the PCT, that is the maximum amount of water as well as the glucose, the useful substances that are reabsorbed. So that is after filtration, it is taken as well in the glomerulus. So what is the site of water filtration? It is in Bowman capsule. And the Bowman capsule, they hold the filtrate. And what happened? It occurred inside the glomerulus. What for the tremendous pressure it is developed? Due to the difference in the domain of afferent and efferent particles. Now, the question, that is, when the filtration is taken place, from which it is filtered? It filters the blood. That is, most of the water as well as the fluid part, as well as some dissolved substances that are filtered. Only which is remained in the efferent arterioles? Only the blood cells which cannot pass through, that are remained inside the blood which passes through the efferent arterioles. Here the water content are also very less, as well as there is some fluid dissolved substances are also less. So the concentration of the blood, it will be more in efferent arterioles. And now when the filtrate it is passes, so it contains large amount of water as well as nitrogenous waste, some useful substances are also there. We get when they pass, that is glucose, that are also reabsorbed. 60% of water of the nephric filter that are also absorbed by the PCT. Then, that is, when it is passed, that are called nephric filter or primary urine. So, the useful substances that are mainly the glucose as well as 60% water is reabsorbed. But the water which already filtered, that should not be released, otherwise the cells become dehydrated. So, the water when passes through the renal tubules, that means from PCT to DCT, throughout the renal tubules, the water it is reabsorbed. Except which region? This part, they do not reabsorb the water. So, we get, that is, here we get this part only impermeable to water, except all the part of the renal tubules, they mainly absorb water, though the maximum absorption of water is taken place by the PCT. Next, amino acids are also reabsorbed, and then the filtrate it moves downwards. That is the Henle's loop. And again, what happens? Simultaneously, when the tubular reabsorption is taken place, that is the tubular secretion, both are take place simultaneously. That means those toxic waste, yet not filtrate, that are also passes through the renal tubules by the process of tubular secretion. But in which process they can pass? Mainly, that is the exchange of reabsorption and secretion. All these are take place by the process of absorption. And which absorption? Active absorption and osmosis, by which, that is, the useful substances, it is mixed again with the blood as well as the toxic waste that are also mixed with the primary urine. And when the primary urine here we get, that is, what type of tubular secretion it is take place, we get creatinine, ammonium radical that are also mixed with it. And what reabsorption it is take place? Selective reabsorption. What selective? That is, here the glucose, then amino acid, and that is the water, large amount water that are reabsorbed by the tubular secretion. So different part we get here. When all these processes are completed, then what happens? That is, from the BCT, the fluid when enter to the collecting tubule, then that are called secondary urine. That are called secondary urine. So the urine primary, it is called primary urine. That means the fluid which are filtered by the glomerulus. And when that are passes through a number of stages and enter into the collecting tubule, that are called secondary urine. What are the difference? Primary urine, it contains some useful substances. What are the useful? We can say glucose, amino acids. But the secondary urine here, the useful substances are not present in normal healthy urine. If there is any problem or any defects is there, then what happens? It can be worse. But a normal healthy urine do not contain some useful substances. When it is passed, that means some defects are also there. Now, that is, in primary urine, it is more dilute because the water content is maximum. And in primary urine, it is highly concentrated. Here the water amount is less. Daily, the secondary urine that are formed in a body, that is 1.5 to 2 liters maximum. But daily in 24 hours in our body, if we measure, that is, the filtration of the primary urine, it can be take place 180 liters. So in how many ratio, that is, the tubular reabsorption is take place, so that the water contained through the, which passes through the secondary urine, that become 1.5. So here, that means maximum water is reabsorbed by the renal tubules when the urine formation takes place by this process. So the first, that is, if it is asked, which is the most, all are the important features. But the first one, that is the ultrafiltration, which occurs through which the toxic substance it is passes. Now the question, when you see the book, that is the renal tubules, that is, we get renal tubules that are mainly covered by what happened in number of blood capillaries. Then what happened? These are all. What is it? That means the current arterioles. Then what happens? They formed. They, that is, these blood capillaries, they covered throughout the renal tubules. And these are called peritubular capillaries or secondary capillaries. And ultimately, these are mixed with, that means they end and join with whom? To the renal vein, which release from the kidney. And ultimately, that is, after filtration, those are toxic that are mixed with the urine, and those are the useful substances that are ultimately joined with the secondary capillaries and they come to the renal vein. And as it is deoxygenated, so what happened? The deoxygenated toxic free blood through the renal artery reach where it bring to the heart, and from the heart again it goes to the lungs for oxygenation. So that is the filtration of the blood is taking place. So these are the different states. We get it. Now that is the nature of the urine. It is depending on the diet. If we consume more, that is the people, those who are vegetarian, here we get their urine mainly, it is alkali in nature. But those are non-vegetarian, their urine, it is acidic in nature. Now, the daily urine, which is passes from our body, that amount, it is, I am told, that is, it is 1.5 to 2 liter. The process by which the urine is removed, you know, first I draw it, that is, the removal of urine from bladder to outside, that are called urination or micturation. Urination and micturation. The formation of urine, that is, mainly, it is taken place by different states, but as well as the circulation of the blood, it is also one of the factors, that is the circulation of blood. So if more physical exercise it can be done, then what happens? Circulation of the blood also increases. When the circulation it is increases, more blood it is reached to the kidney, more filtration it is taken. The physical exercise as well as the urine, it is depend on the diet. If you consume more dilute diet, then what happened? Urine formation, it will be more. It also depend, that is, during daytime, when our physical exercise, physical activities, it will be more. Because at night, we take rest, we are in sleep. Most of the time, that is suppose 6-7 hours we are completely rest. So in compared to the night, day time, we do more physical activities. So what happens when more physical activities is there, more blood circulation, so that time, that is urine formation, it will be more. That means frequency of urine, it is also more in daytime. So the urine, it is depend on some factor, that is physical exercise, day, time, as well as the diet. And there are some substances which also increase the intensity of the urine that are called diuretic substances, like tea, coffee, alcohol. If you consume more, then what happens? That is more urine formation, it is stiffness. So we get, that is, there are a number of differences we will get over here. The first thing you can write. Write the homework. Difference between renal cortex and renal medulla. Next you write. That is, ascending and descending limb of Henle's loop. Next, ureter and urethra. Difference, ureter and urethra. Next difference you write, afferent arterioles, efferent arterioles, afferent and efferent arterioles. Next, you write. So you will complete all these differences.